When we think of martial arts movies, stars such as Bruce Lee, Jackie Chan, and Jet Li come to mind. But the genre has a long history of female martial artists. In this video, we examine the dimensions of femme fatales in the martial arts world. Maternal. Some women balance their motherly skills with their deadly martial arts. In Kill Bill, Beatrix Kiddo and Vernita Green's duel is interrupted by the arrival of Vernita's daughter.
Mommy, I'm home.
Hey, baby. How was school?
Beatrix shows her motherly side when scolding a child in the crazy 88 gang.
This is what you get for fucking around with Yakuzas! Go home to your mother!
Katara, a waterbending master from Avatar: The Last Airbender, assumes a motherly role to her traveling friends.
Aang, you'll hurt yourself!
She also develops healing powers. In Shinobi, Heart Under Blade, Oguro forgoes her lover to serve as the matriarch for her entire tribe. In Drunken Master, Jackie Chan plays troublemaker Freddie Wong, who tricks a girl into kissing and hugging him. This provokes the ire of her mother, and Freddie gets his just desserts.
Thought you could come fresh with my daughter, did you?
Tomboy. Some women reject maternal roles, favoring their masculine sides. In season 2 of Avatar, we meet Toph Bifong, a blind earthbender and undefeated champion of a professional wrestling tournament. A foil to the motherly Katara, Toph is sarcastic, independent, and confrontational. As senior inspectors Ng and Morris in Yes, Madam, running the show in the Hong Kong police force and bringing down a big crime ring. In Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, Jin, disguised as a man, creates a stir by picking a bar fight.
To know who I am? I am Invisible Sword Goddess! With the green destiny that knows no equal!
Seductress. Other women use their sexuality as a weapon. In Reign of Assassins, Turquoise's sexuality is exclusively expressed through violence.
Luckily for her.
In a gritty animated scene from Kill Bill, 11-year-old Oren Ishii avenges the murder of her parents by sleeping with the Yakuza boss, plunging a katana into his chest during the act. The 17-year-old Gogo Yubare, bodyguard of Oren Ishii, combines sexy schoolgirl with sadistic killer.
どっちだ。やりたい。どうなのさ。これでもまだ私を刺した。でも逆に刺されちゃったみたい。Kagero
from Shinobi is a literal example of this. Her body is filled with poison, giving her a deadly kiss. Now that we've seen these three archetypes, we may ask ourselves if they can overlap. Maternal figures and tomboys are often at opposite ends of a spectrum.
You're not my mom and you're not their mom. I never said I was. No, but you certainly act like it.
Likewise, the masculinity of tomboys precludes using their feminine wiles. However, sexuality and maternity can overlap in the same character. For instance, Jade Fox treats Jen like a daughter, but also uses her sexuality to gain access and assassinate a Wudan master.
Yeah,